In Indonesian waters off the coast of the island of Sumatra, these fishermen are trying to do whatever they can to help people in desperate need. This vessel carrying more than 100 Rohingya refugees was spotted near Aceh province on Sunday. Local fishermen said they felt sorry for those on board, particularly the young children.
According to our radio communication, they are weak. Someone died, some are sick, including many children, and the elderly are getting weaker. According to our information, they've been at sea for 28 days.
Fishermen told Al Jazeera they have been providing food, medicine and water to those on board, but have not been allowed to help them get to shore. Local authorities in Aceh say they will assist the Rohingya and give them essential supplies, but won't allow them into the country.
The job of the Navy is to secure our border. The Rohingya are not Indonesian citizens. We cannot bring them in, even as refugees. This is in line with government policy.
Police say the Rohingya were trying to reach Malaysia. Thousands of Rohingya have fled Myanmar to neighbouring Bangladesh in recent years, escaping a military crackdown that the UN says amounts to genocide. Facing poverty in crowded refugee camps, many try to reach safety in Southeast Asian countries. Last year, a group of Rohingya refugees was saved by fishermen and brought to shore after their boat broke down near Aceh. But some fishermen told Al Jazeera they were afraid of repercussions if they attempted a rescue this time. Indonesia is not a signatory to the UN Convention on Refugees and is seen as a transit country for refugees making dangerous journeys at sea. Still, human rights groups say Indonesia must do more as a regional power in Southeast Asia.
To push the boat back is a violation of international obligations of Indonesia. I think international law clearly imposes obligations on states, including Indonesia, to protect human rights of refugees arriving on their shores.
The Indonesian government has not responded to Al Jazeera's requests for comment, and after so many days at sea, these desperate people still face an uncertain future. Jessica Washington, Al Jazeera, Jakarta.